Now our travels take us to a beautiful beach. Can you smell the fresh open air? And here we reveal an essential part of programming, like stacking stones when defining programming instructions for a specific task. Order matters. Imagine how different our pet cafe program would work, or not work, if the instructions were followed in no particular order. The program can't display information before asking the user for it, and it can't make a decision before it has the information it needs to make that decision. The set of instructions for a task has a particular order, or flow, from one instruction to the next. As software developers, we control the flow of those instructions using a few key constructs. We use if statements when we need the computer to make a decision. That decision is often based on input, like the user-entered type of pet. And we have a repeat, or a loop in programming terms, when we want to repeat some instructions. We often provide some way to end the loop. In this example, the loop stops after displaying the text once for each pet. The if and loop are examples of flow of control statements. Control flow refers to the order our provided instructions are processed by the computer, and flow of control statements can impact that flow. Back in the olden days, software developers learned how to flowchart their flow of control, like this. We start with an oval to mark the beginning of the program. We use a parallelogram for any input or output, like displaying a message. We use a diamond for a decision with branches for the options. Each of our if statements are represented with a diamond because they indicate a decision. So if the user picks cat, it displays meow. It then loops until it's looped once for each pet, so the computer can count the loops and stop when it's displayed a message for each pet. And we do the same if the user picks dog. Lastly, we define an oval at the end of the program. Software developers don't generally use flowcharts anymore because most programs have become much more complex that can be adequately or usefully shown on these diagrams, but they are helpful when starting out to visualize a program's flow. And here's a tip. Consider using a flowchart, even just a rough one, when working through complex logic. There may be times when we want the computer to make a decision based on multiple pieces of information instead of just one. In that case, we use and or. For example, if a pet is a dog and a small breed, display yelp. If the pet is a dog and a large breed, display woof. If the pet is a dog or a cat, display grrr. I feel like I'm reading a children's book here. Okay, let's keep going. We use and if we want all factors to be true. Pet is a dog and a small breed. And use or if we want at least one of the factors to be true. Pet is a dog or a cat. But how about this one? If the pet is a dog or a cat and asleep, display What decision are we expecting from this? Do we want a dog or a cat that is asleep? So any dog but only sleeping cats? Or do we want a dog or cat and they are asleep? Computers are very strict about how they interpret and or, so take care when you mix them. Here we use parentheses to make it clear to the computer how we want the and or to be combined. So, in programming, order matters when defining the instructions for a task. Decisions in a program are specified with an if statement. Use and or to make a decision based on multiple factors. Repeat instructions using a loop. If statements and loops are two key ways to control program flow. But when building an entire application with lots of tasks and instructions, how can we better organize these instructions? Let's look at that next.